morning, an Indianapolis 7th grader hopes to become the youngest Indy 500 champ in history, but it's his accomplishments off the track that are making a big difference.
The 7-time National Go-kart Points Champion started a charity in memory of an IndyCar driver whose words he says changed the way that he viewed himself and the education of others. Our Colby Thelen explaining.
In this 7th grader's bedroom, you won't find much shelf space or uncovered walls.
A lot of wins and podiums.
Yes, Elliot Cox has a lot of decorations.
I've won a few, yeah.
He remembers each one. His mom Amanda remembers how it all began, a trip to the store with Grandpa.
My dad called and said they needed help unloading. We open it up and it's this little car.
So we take it home. My mom freaks out and said we never drive it anywhere but the grass.
He had just turned 5 and I'm like, Dad, you have lost your mind.
And his first time behind the wheel.
Got out and said, God made me to do this. And I was like, oh man.
Racing seemed to come naturally to Elliot. However, reading did not. He was diagnosed with dyslexia at the age of 6.
And I did get called stupid and dumb. And I didn't ever want to read out loud.
But he would soon find encouragement through racing and words of one driver in particular. Justin Wilson.
He was an IndyCar driver that had dyslexia. So I got to meet with him and he told me that dyslexia doesn't make you stupid and that I shouldn't let it stop me.
But in 2015, the Pocono Raceway, Wilson was killed when a piece of debris struck his helmet.
When Justin passed away, he had said that he wanted to carry on Justin's legacy because Justin had helped him so much and it meant so much to him.
Elliot started a charity called Driving for Dyslexia. To this day, he's raised more than $78,000.
It just means a lot to me because I don't want other kids to feel stupid like I did. And I just want to raise money for tutors so they can teach other kids how to read better and how just to like not let dyslexia get in the way of everything.
What do you think that Justin would say now, looking at what you've been able to do?
I honestly don't know. I think he would say good job and keep doing it, but that's just what I think.
Colby Thelen, Fox 59 News.
Elliot enrolled in the Hoosier Academy last year, and he says the online classes help him get individual attention and also continue his busy racing schedule.
Elliot will soon move up to the next level of go-kart racing, 80 mile an hour. So that'll be good. Of course, yeah. He is thrilled, but mom is still pretty nervous, but that's expected. Now, of course, Justin, I mean, he's just such a wonderful guy.
Yeah. The nicest of the nice.
Literally the nicest one.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
the kids already has an aerodynamic hairdo.
He sure does.
He does. I'm kind of jealous. I'm like, what kind of hair product does he use? He had a nice little, he's got that whole thing going.
Is that
there.
Dan? Like, Dan?
Yeah.
He got that good. From Elio.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't climb the fence.
Exactly. Not yet. All right. We are.